Now, from China, the good news seems to be that the rate of infections has slowed, but the worrying news is a Beijing-based news outlet reports is that local officials in China's Guangdong province say 14% of patients who recovered from the virus then tested positive again. Now, we don't know, the researchers don't know if the patients were then infectious again, and the positive readings were weak. They were readings taken not from, as is normal, from the nose or throat, but from anal swabs. Still, it's a concern, and this has a long way to go. Joining me is the panel, former New South Wales Liberal leader Kerry Chikarovski and Graham Richardson, former Labor Minister and host at Sky News. Kerry, the Prime Minister today said the government's starting the first phase of Australia's emergency response plan because the risk, he said, of a global pandemic is very much upon us. Well, I'm not sure what more they're going to do they haven't done already, but how's the government handling this problem so far?
Well, I think they're handling it quite well because we've seen that we haven't had a huge number of cases in Australia. The people who were infected who came into the country have been pretty quickly identified and been put into isolation. So it's not as if we're concerned about a massive number of people in the greater Australian community who've come in contact with these people who are now spreading the virus. I think they're being calm. They're actually not trying to panic people, and, you know, all power to President Trump because he's trying to do the same thing in the United States. But I, as you pointed out, the concern about this is perhaps other countries which have not had the same sort of level of response and don't have the resources to respond in the way that Australia and the United States have responded. You know, you ask, why is it that little towns in places like Iran have been affected by this? You know, why is it that... Why is that being, you know, that infection not being brought under control? How is it that Pakistan has now got infection in its country? So, and now if it does have, well, if it's only, if it's got two people in Pakistan who have been infected, how quickly could it spread in a country as populated as Pakistan if those people hadn't been isolated in time? So I think the Australian response, I think the American response, I think, you know, I'm surprised at the Italian response. I'm surprised that it's gone so quickly there. And in some ways, I'm surprised at the Japanese response because they knew that they had a lot of people sitting on a cruise ship. And from what we read, they didn't probably make sure that when those people were coming back into the community that they did so in a safe enough way.
That's absolutely correct. I think there's been some misjudgment of how infectious this disease is. Graham, more than 500 Chinese students trapped in Wuhan back in China have asked the Morrison government if they can fly a chartered plane at their own cost over to Christmas Island to, you know, serve quarantine there, to get out of China but also to get to Australia and start studying here again. Is there anything in this proposal that we should be smiling at, do you think?
When was the last time you heard of this? The last time people just paying to hire a plane? You know how much planes cost to hire? This doesn't cost two bob. This is a massive exercise. I saw that report and I smiled. I thought, well, wow, we must have some very, very wealthy people coming to study here. Very wealthy indeed.
Yeah, well, if they've got that money and they want to do it, I don't know. Maybe we should consider it. I don't know. Although the cost of quarantining and the risk is to be borne by Australia. But it shows how desperate some people are and how the world is changing.
But it's also, can I just say, Andrew, it's an interesting commitment to the Australian education system that they are so desperate to come back here because they recognise the quality of the education that they're getting here and they don't want to fall behind in their studies. So, yep, I'm not quite sure how they're going to afford it, but obviously they think they can. And I actually think it's something, yeah, and I think it's something that the government should actually look at.
Yes, when I said smiling at it, I mean with favour.